Next, we're going to find out how to download Audacity from the Internet. As you can see, I have Internet Explorer open on my computer, and I'm on the website for Google. And the website for Google is www.google.ca, or you can use google.com if you'd like. So, I'm going to search for Audacity in Google. And in my results, you'll notice at the very top, it says Audacity, free audio editor and recorder. I'll click on that link, and it takes me directly to the Audacity page. Now, that's the easiest way I find to tell people to find Audacity. The other option would be to type in the address, which you can see here in the address bar. But as you can see, it's a little bit cryptic. http://audacity.soundforge.net. It's a little easier to go to Google and do a search for Audacity and find it that way. But we're here. Next, we're going to try to download Audacity. And you can see here in the middle of the page, there's a link called Download Audacity 1.2.6. Now, below that, it says Download Audacity 1.3.2 Beta. I would stay away from the beta if I were you. The beta is a test version of Audacity. It's a newer version, has different features, newer features, but it's still in testing stage, and it may not be very stable. So I would go with the released version 1.2.6. Now, if you're watching this this video at a later date, the version may be upgraded. They may have released a version 2 or maybe a version 3. Whichever the most stable version is, and that would be the one that they present here on this page. So just stay away from the beta and you'll be fine. So click that link. Next, we're at the Audacity, we're getting close to the Audacity download page. And it says here, recommended download, and you can read this documentation if you like. But if you can see here, download Audacity 1.2.6 installer. That's what we need. So we'll click on that link. Once you've clicked on that link, you'll be taken to this next page, and Audacity will begin to download automatically. Now, it's going to ask you where you'd like to save it, so you can click the Save button, and you can identify a place where you'd like to save it. I'm going to put it in My Documents. Now, you can start. I'm going to start a new folder here for Audacity to download in, just to keep it nice and tidy. I'll call it Audacity. And then I'll just save the file into that folder. Save. Audacity will download quickly, and then once it's done, we can proceed. Now, once Audacity has downloaded to your computer, you want to navigate to the folder where you saved it. Now, you may have decided to save it on the desktop. We'll go through the desktop and find it. Or, as I did, I made a folder called Audacity in my Documents folder. So you can see it here. I'm in the folder called Audacity, and you can see here's the file I downloaded. Double-click on that file. This is the Audacity installer. And as you can see, we'll be taken into an install wizard. You can click Next. Now, here's the licensing agreement. I would advise you to read every word of this so that you know exactly what you're doing by clicking I accept. I accept the agreement. So you have to click that you accept and then click Next. And then once again, you're given some more information. You can read this if you like. It's information about the software. And click Next again. This asks us where we want to save our Audacity files. This is fine. The default is fine. I would recommend you leave it there in the program files folder. Click Next again. It says that this folder doesn't exist. Would you like to create one? And you would say yes. Now, this next selection here, it asks, do we want to create a desktop icon? And do we want to associate Audacity files with Audacity? And I would select both of those. Next, and then the last one is, this will now install Audacity on your computer. And once that's done, we'll have a finish button and it will select Launch Audacity. I would do that just to make sure it's okay and click Finish. And the last thing is Audacity will start up for us and we can see that it's running okay.